Hello everyone, I am Martin Fenska and welcome to another part of Let's Play Eador, Masters of the Broken World on Overlord difficulty. In this part, again, I want to fight as much as possible, but I changed the target priority a bit. Initially, I wanted to go back to the second ring immediately, bring some more units to the wizard and start clearing locations here, but the fight in the previous part against clerics made me think that maybe we are not strong enough to attack some other things in the capital, and it wasn't just me thinking this. Also, in one comment there was a suggestion that might be worth it checking this retinue just to see how strong it is, and that it might be doable, and I think it actually is doable until there is something crazy like 15 units supported it, or one of them being tier 4. So I will check what is there. And also we have a vampire. I hope it's only one vampire. It should be. That's another fight we should be able to do, and maybe even trolls. So change of plans before we go to the second ring. I will try some more fights in the capital. For the retinue, you'll probably need some cannon fodder. So I'll take a full army for this fight. The goal is to have the hero and the healer alive in the end of the fight, but just those two. I want the experience to be divided only between them. Now, I don't care about these melee units. Even I don't even care about the spearmen. Actually, that's a unit I want to lose the most, because he is very weak, and with the metal, he's pretty expensive. So, completely useless unit. I just want to get rid of it. If I didn't have a fight where I could use him just to take a few hits, I just dismiss him immediately and hire the barbarian. But in this fight, well, he can do something useful and die for us. So that's what I'll try to do with him. The remaining barbarians can die as well. They have no experience, so it's just like throwing away 30 gold, and we can afford that. And after the fight, we can just hire new units. We are in the capital, so that's okay. Maybe if we are on full hit points, I try to do it like without losses, just because, you know, I prefer doing fights that way. Even when I like intentionally go into fight and I like want to sacrifice units there, I still feel like it wasn't a good fight because something died. But here, well, whatever. We are on 56 hit points. We'll need some extra time to heal up before we send the hero forward. So this is much safer. So that's the plan, and after the fight, and depending on how many hit points we have left, we'll decide on what's gonna be next. I of course can't attack like a vampire on 30 hit points, for example, or same with trolls, especially in a swamp. I will try to get out of the fight with full hit points if possible. But enough talking, let's start playing. So that's the target, and let's see. This looks good. It's only 11 units, that's even less than I expected. Tier 3 unit, yeah, that was to be expected. I just have to make sure the knight dies before it does too much damage. Maybe same with the horseman. Just hope that there are not too many knights and horsemen dead. Could cause some problems. But we are in the swamp, they should be slowed by the terrain. Yep, I think we can do it. I don't like this at all. There's way too much damage focused here. Not only the mounted units, but also the supported from the ranged units. Okay. I need the healing. Maybe I'll just heal once and then send the hero forward. I need to start doing damage as soon as possible. Weaken them before they get too close to the healer. I'm afraid that they might be able to overwhelm us. This is probably the best I can do. I hope they're gonna divide, and these two will just slow down at least two units. This is not bad. Especially the bowman going back. Okay, let's get the heal. Move forward. I'll use astral energy already. Move once again. And now use magic armor. I want to have the magic armor up already. So that's why I had to do it with the astral energy. Okay. Oh, I didn't see this attack. But why not? And it's proc the berserk. That's perfect. Okay, I think you can stay here, just do damage, do a lot of damage. Those crossbowmen are quite annoying. Why the hell are you running away? Even on 3 hit points, I want to kill him. I don't want to have a unit that is so mobile, roaming around the map. It's hard to predict what's it gonna do when, you know, you have something with movement of 4 and it's in range of like your whole army. It always can find way to weaken the unit or something and finish it off. Okay, that's fine. This hurt, and this hurt as well. Oh, good. He survived. That's unexpected. But the hero needs healing now. So let's get back. And just wait for them. Okay, that's fine. Ow. Yeah, this is what I was talking about. I didn't expect this guy moves up. I was hoping those barbarians will keep the knight busy for like 3 more turns. Not ideal with the hero standing in the swamp. But he should be fine. Next turn, I'll have to use the magic armor again. Okay. This has to be a heal. This guy can die now. I'll replace him with the hero and hopefully we'll get rid of the guardsmen. Good. And what about the knight? Oh, just running around like a headless chicken. Good. That's what we need. We need some more time to clear the area around the army. This is still fine. Oh, this is not fine. Well, I don't have a choice. I have to start attacking. And I have to block the path for the swordsmen. I hope I now can afford to lose the spearman. How much ammo do the crossbowmen have? I think we are fine. Okay, kill this one now. Heal the hero. So those were last bolts from crossbowmen, and the bowman has two arrows left, but has no stamina. Okay, now we just heal the hero, and we are ready for the next fight. So everything worked quite well. Sacrificed all units that we wanted to sacrifice. The hero is back to full hit points. Good. That was another pretty decent fight. That was the level of the knight, 8. That's not bad. And we should get quite a lot of gold from this. 200 and a level up with the command, that's bad, and abilities are pretty bad as well. Now the question is, do you want extra initiative and forced march, or you want to start working on combat to get to a round attack, just extremely strong. So it's on level 5, so it will be ages before we get there. I think I'll start with the athletics, just to get the forest march. Then maybe get back to something else, like the armor master would be amazing. Your charge is also good. But again, it's level 4, so long time. And before that, I'm not the that good level ups. But the forest march is definitely useful, so let's take it. And here we have a serpent amulet. Could be useful. Extra morale, extra stamina. The rest is garbage, but we are doing this fight for the experience, not for the loot. So it's fine. Continue. What's this? Spiders. No. Whatever. I don't care. They are quite happy, so this won't affect them basically at all. Okay. Now we have to repair the gear, that's the first thing. And I think I will sell these amulets and equip the serpent one. Extra initiative, I think it's much better than one morale. Repair. Now, how long do we need to get to Necromancer's Guild. Aegis. So that's not gonna work. I'd really like to get to Vampirism before we leave the capital, but it's obviously not gonna happen. Just thinking if it's worth delaying the work on the Seafarer's Guild. I think it might be. But the problem is, I'm still not sure which magic schools I want to build yet. I want to get the School of Necromancy, definitely. Then I want to get some School of Wizardry, but the fourth one, as usual, I really don't know. I'd like to get, where is it, Haste, and later maybe Stone Skin. Those are pretty good. Word of Life is amazing, though it's much better for Dark Knight with extra buff duration, with only like 3 turn duration. It's maybe not that good. Maybe you can pass on the healing spells. And also the Chaos Magic is something we should think about, because we are thinking about demons for the next chart, so maybe you could already start to work on that. I think we're gonna end up with Wizardry, Necromancy, and Chaos. Okay, well, so let's do that. I want those spells. And I think we will get to Adragoran through the south anyway, so we won't need the Seafarer's Guild. Now, we don't need the healer for the next fight, because we're gonna attack vampires. And we can end the turn. No surprise, only one. I want him to stand and swamp, if possible. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this should work. And the important thing is, there we have magic armor up before he attacks. This is gonna hurt. Vampire can do a lot of damage. Okay, and we are down to 48 points. So I think trolls. Well, if we hire again some cannon fodder, we will have time to heal. I think we can still do them. Okay, but the loot here is horrible. We can keep exploring. Get rid of the stuff, repair the gear again. And how many units do I want to take with me? Again, I want all of them to die, so I don't have to share the experience. I think just 3. Attack trolls. And we built another school of magic. Necromancy this time. And they are really expensive thanks to the Mandrake. Okay, go. Oh, it's only two. For some reason, I thought you'll have more of them. Okay, whatever. The plan is still the same. Heal up the hero. Delay them a bit. I think I'll already use the magic armor. Oh, maybe this wasn't the best idea, attacking him while he's standing in the swamp. I'll have to retreat the next turn. Maybe even two tiles. Okay, we need to cast the magic armor again, and now it should be easier. Get the last barbarian down, but also this troll is almost dead. And let's get some healing. Come on. Oh, maybe I should have turned. I want to attack. I think I do, because we have the Berserk active, so it's a lot of damage. Heal again. And now we can finish him off. Okay. Good. Level up for the healer. That'll be resistance. And these items you definitely want to sell. Or maybe, no. I'm thinking about giving them to the wizard, but he doesn't need anything. I'm not gonna transfer any gear anyway. Okay, and we have a level up. More magic. From these abilities, I think just the magic power. The rest. I'm not a big fan of the wand mastery. On level 4 and 5, the boost damage is not bad. Level 5, the extra range, why not, but still. Like, never need this on such high levels. When you can get to like level 5 of any skill, your spells are so strong that you like never use your wand. Let's take the spell power. Okay, here we have to invest some more gold. And build the Altar of Chaos. Mm-hmm. And again, repair the gear. Sell everything we don't need. And now. You want to change the spell setup. I don't think so. I'm thinking about taking one magic weapon instead of one astral energy, but I think I'd rather have the stamina and booster resistance. That means we just need some units. There will be two for the wizard, and I want two to protect the healer. I'll most likely die pretty soon, but for now I will take them. The hero still needs a bit before I can run a solo. I think the vampirism is the most important thing right now. Once you get that, we'll be able to start running solo or a weapon that would give us a life leech, because the healing in combat is really bad. We just have some basic regeneration and that's not enough. Or another thing would be if we could get a lot of armor, because for now we are really taking a lot of damage. Even with the magic armor, the defense is still like 7 or 8. That's not that much. Against tier 3 units, we need like, I don't know, 12 at least. So for now, we need the healer. And as long as we have a healer, we need some other units to protect him. Simple as that. Okay. Go. And maybe I should check Adragoran. I said that I want to keep an eye on him. And forget that. Trolls. More trolls. Why am I not surprised? And this is what I wanted to see. Because I don't know if you remember, Adragoran lost the Centaur province. And I wanted to know what's he gonna do about it. And now we can see it. He reconquered it. I bet that he's gonna lose it again, like in, I don't know, 5 turns, because he doesn't have a guard here. And once Centaurs get unhappy, it's extremely hard to make them happy again. So, unless he hires some decent guard here, he'll keep losing the province. But more important thing is, I think you notice it already, he lost his scout in the fight. Scout is not on the map. And the only explanation is either there is some bug with the graphics, but I've never seen a bug like that. And the only other option is he lost the hero. So it seems the AI is actually decent as long as its provinces are quiet. Once it starts to have problems with rebellions in its own provinces, the AI is just horrible. So that's something developers should do. Have a look at and maybe improve it. It really make the AI hire like the strongest guards in provinces where it has population mood problems, prevent all this trouble from happening, and then the AI should be much better, I think. It's from what we can see on this chart, it's really the only problem Adragoran has, but it's such a big problem for him that he basically lost the chart because of that. Okay, well, I'll check him again in a few turns. I really want to know What's he gonna do about the province? And for now, what do we have? Quite a few targets. Well, we can start with Lizardman, whatever. I want to clear all of it anyway. But before we end the turn, let's transfer those barbarians, and I'll take the rivet jacket in case we get to a shop so we can sell it. Okay, and you will equip the coat. Okay, next we build Sorcerer's Workshop and end the turn. Oh, this is pretty decent. Okay, and it should be quite easy. Okay, make sure that the healer is protected. Start the fight. And now, what resistance do we need to be immune to petrification? I'm not sure if it's 5 or 6. I think it's 6. Well, let's move forward. Use the armor. Now I move again. Try to do everything I can to protect or prevent the petrification, and let's see what's gonna happen. So far, so good. But every turn I have to keep an eye on the buff duration, because when the Astral Energy buff drops, he'll get petrified immediately. Come on. Move. Okay. That's still fine. And now we start working on the first basilisk. I didn't really want to give the kill to the barbarian, but it didn't have a choice. I need to kill at least one basilisk, so I had to attack him. Okay, this is fine. Man, another kill for barbarians. Well, whatever. At this point, the hero should be getting so much experience. He's doing almost all the fighting alone. Okay, let's get the heal. Last astral energy. Maybe we can even kill the basilisk? No, not yet. Okay, that was easy, but still decent fight. Let's see. Berserk. Yeah, sure. More survivability. These barbarians are not here to deal damage, so I can take a purely defensive medal. And we have Rain of Stones. I was hoping this was a tier 2 scroll, so I was hoping that we will see, you know, the Vampirism or a Fireblade, something useful, but no. Rain of Stones. Well, we can at least sell this. Keep exploring. What was the location that we just found? Oh, these lost souls. I was hoping it was another vampire. Never mind. Okay, demons will be next. Before we end the turn, we can build something. I think Sage's Guild now. So we have the option to build libraries if we need one. How does it look like with the gear? 57. We need a shield. The rest of the gear should be fine, almost no damage, but because the hero is fighting so much, the durability of the weapon will go down really fast. So it basically will be the same every time, just lose all durability on the weapon and the rest of our gear will be untouched almost. So now we need the secondary weapon, which means the Berserker's Axe. With a shield, you can still use the halberd. It's not that good. But it will have to do. It seems. How much durability does it have? 60. Yeah. So at the time that both the weapon lose the durability, the rest of the armor should start breaking down as well. Okay. I want to avoid going away from this province like every three turns to repair. That would be a waste of time. And it seems that Atragon really lost the hero. I wanted to confirm it, and it's nowhere to be seen. It has to be dead. He will have to wait a while before he can resurrect him. I think that he may have some problems with gold. That would be the explanation why he still doesn't have a guard in this province. You can see that he has guards everywhere. And that means when he can hire a guard, he does that. So the only reason why he didn't do it in this province is that he doesn't have gold for that, and if he doesn't have gold for guard, he may not have gold for the hero, or he doesn't have gold for the hero, because the higher level the hero is, the more expensive it is to resurrect him. So yeah, here is a really good and clear example of what's happening always with AIs, why they're failing so much, and it really is the same as what we can see on every shard. When you think about that, always, because we can see their borders through the fog of war, you know, we can like follow their progress on every shard, even if there is a fog of war. We can see their borders expanding pretty quickly, but then suddenly they stop, and when we attack them, they really don't have anything that impressive, and I think it's always the same. They just expand, and then suddenly they start having problems with their conquered provinces. They don't know how to handle it. They end up losing their hero. Then they just run out of money, can't resurrect the heroes, and they just wait until they get conquered. And I'd even bet that it's the problem, like, I don't know, at least 90% of the shards. So this would be something I'd look at as a developer, to how to change this. And I think really the problem is only with the rebelling provinces. Solve that problem and AIs should become a lot better. But well, that's not a problem for us to solve. Our problem is how to get to Atragoran. And I think we are quite close to solving that problem. A few more level ups, then we can attack these orcs. once we have this province, we can talk to Lizardman, get the quest for an alliance, and once we have the alliance, the Shard is basically over, because getting through the Centauris, that will be, you know, a joke. At that point, the hero will be like level 17, 18, and he'll kill them quite easily. So, it's pretty obvious what we want to do on this Shard. I think like 3-4 more parts and this will be over, and then we're gonna attack a Dragaren, and I think that will be a lot more challenging, because we'll try that demon army with the wizard, and that's something I actually like never tried. Always when I was thinking about demons, I started playing, and after a while I just change the build into something that I know. So we'll see how that works, but it's still far away. In the next part, yeah, we're gonna fight, we're gonna get more experience, and I hope you join me again. And until then, have a good time. Bye bye.